Again, guys, with the group functions, we know that we are feeding the entire column or the entire table in some cases. But what if I want the total number of salaries for specific departments? Let me first talk about the scenario and then I'll get into the next concept. See, my requirement is I want to know for all the individual department IDs, what is the maximum salary an employee is getting? Like for department number 90, who's the employee who's getting the highest salary? For department number 100, who's the employee who's getting the highest salary? For the department number 30, who's the employee who's getting the highest salary? Now, these kind of requirements will come when you as a DBA work on reporting databases or data warehouse databases. In those scenarios, you will be using all these functions to create reports that will further go to your testing team or business development team. This is a very genuine requirement. Again, you need to differentiate between what we just saw and what we are going to see. Just now, we were trying to feed the entire record or entire column into the function, the group functions. Like if you see over here, we feed the complete salary column into the minimum function. And after analyzing the entire salary column, we got the minimum salary, right? The same goes with max salary. So we are actually feeding the entire column into the max function. But now my requirement is I want to find out the maximum salary based on the departments. So for department number 30, first I want to know the maximum salary. Then I want to know department number 50 maximum salary. So we want to group the data. We are trying to group our output data based on group by clause. So what's the new thing that we are going to learn? It's group by clause. So what is this group by clause? Okay. Group by clause is used to group data sets and feed into group functions. So our requirement right now is I want to group the data based on the department, because for each department, each single department, I want to know the maximum salary. So that means I'm not feeding the entire table. I want to feed the max function, the data based on departments. So first I will feed the data for department number 90 and then we'll get the max salary. Then I want to feed the all the salaries for the department ID 60 and then get the maximum salary and so on. So how do we do it? We will be using the group function. It's like group by function. So how the query will look like, let me write query for you guys so it will be easy for you to follow. Select, we want to find the maximum salary, okay? So the query is simple. Select max salary, perfect. And we also want to count the number of employees in that department. Just for our purpose, I'm trying to make it more complex. Count star from hr.employees. Perfect. Till here, the query is normal. It's very simple. Now, I don't want to feed the entire salary column, but I want to feed the data based on the department. So I want to group the data based on department IDs and then feed it to the max function. So we'll use group by clause, group by department underscore ID, and let us run this query. I think I should have typed the query over here itself. That's okay. Now when we run this query, we can see that, okay, in this case we are not getting the department ID, so what I'll do is I'll actually query the department column, also department ID, department ID. Now we will have the details of all the departments, their maximum salary and the total number of employees. Now can you see this one? We have department number 100, the maximum salary is 12,000, and then the total number of employees in this department ID are 6. The department ID is 30, the maximum salary is 11,000, and there are total number of 6 employees. There is one department ID which is null, and the maximum salary is 7,000, and there is only one employee, right? The same way we can go with department ID 50, and in the department 50 we have 8,200 and there are 45 employees. Now if you just want to cross check whether this output is correct or not, what I will do is I will select count star from hr.employees. Sorry guys, my phone, I forgot to put it on silent, give me a minute. Okay, select count star from hr.employees where department underscore ID is equal to 50. I'm just verifying the data whether we really have 45 employees in the department number 50, and let us run this query. Perfect, we have 45 employees who are under department number 50. That means this query result is perfect. So the group by clause is used to feed the data to the group functions in a data set rather than feeding the entire column or the entire table. That's our first learning with group by clause.